Hadith 5. Rejection of evil deeds and innovations. On the authority of the mother of the faithful, Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, who said, the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, he who innovates something in this manner of ours, Islam, that is not of it, will have it rejected by Allah. Bukhari and Muslim. In one version by Muslim, it reads, he who does an act which we have not commanded will have it rejected by Allah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ولا. This hadith actually is one of the basic hadith that complements hadith number one in the series, and I would advise my brothers and sisters to refer back to it. Hadith Umar, that the deeds are by their intention. You know, that hadith basically describes the internal dimension of the deeds that we do, and this one describes the outer dimension of the things that we do. And for any action to be accepted, it has to be sound in both ways, in both aspects. So the inside has to be sound, as well as this one has to be sound. And in this hadith, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, anything or any action that is invented in our religion is rejected, then the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام gives us a basis for protecting this religion. And this hadith is the basis of defining an important resonating concept in the religion, which is the bid'ah, of course, that everybody likes to talk about. And probably the best definition that was given to the bid'ah is the one given by Shatibi, when he said, it's an invented way in the deen that competes with the shari'i way, with the legitimate way, whereby the person seeks to exaggerate the worship. And I think this has several key elements in there. First of all, is that al-bid'ah, the way we know it, is not any innovation, but it's an innovation actually in the aspects of, in the stricter aspect of the religion, the deen, as far as rituals as well as worships. Not any innovation in that regard. So here, and he says basically that the purpose of the bid'ah is to seek to exaggerate the worship. And that's really what makes it a little dangerous, that sometimes we think that more is better, but the Prophet ﷺ is clearly indicating to us that more is not better. The best is what the Prophet did. Afterward, you start going downhill. You know, as the famous story of the three men that were standing by the door of the Prophet, long story short, where one of them said, I will fast every day. The other one, I will never get married. And the other one said, I will have qiyam every night. And the Prophet said, I get married, I fast, sometimes I sleep. And he said, and this is my sunnah, my path. And anyone that deviates away from my path is not of me. So again, the Prophet is clearly indicating that more actually is not better. And I think the important aspect to keep in mind is that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that today I have completed your religion and I perfected it for you, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم, which means it is perfect the way it is. You know, if something is perfect, you can't take away from it and you can't add to it. It will not be perfect anymore. And we have to believe that we have enough in the guidance of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام to satisfy our needs. So we don't have to come up with something new. Whatever we need to know about the religion, about getting close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam has described it to us. So that's why this hadith anyway puts that into perspective, that anything that's beyond the guidance of the Prophet in that regard, in that context, is rejected. Because subhanAllah, deviations start with a small change. You know, it's like somebody who's going in a circle, in a closed circle. If you take a small angle at one point, then you start getting further and further away. And that's what happened, by the way. A lot of the deviant groups start with a small deviations that keep on building up until suddenly they find themselves completely actually in a strange place. And the other aspect in here is that the person who spends too much time or invests too much time and energy in performing a certain bid'ah, that's going to take away from the energy that he would have spent actually with following the guidance of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Because we only have actually a limited amount of energy, obviously. If I spend much of it in bid'ah, there'll be less of it in the sunnah, so to speak. But I think the important thing to keep in mind as well when dealing with the bid'ah is that not all the bid'ah's innovations, in that sense, by the way, again, not any innovation goes under the bid'ah, but when we're talking about bid'ah in the deen, not all of them actually are of the same kind. You know, at the highest level, you have the bid'ah that affects the aqidah, the basics of belief. And here, these have to be changed, you know, as far as enjoining the good and forbidding the evil, because that's the biggest harm that could be, a bid'ah in the aqidah. But you also have certain bid'ah in the behavior or in the practice that may not be directly related to the aqidah, that has no basis in the religion. And in that regard, and this is something that has to be changed, so long as it does not lead to something, to a bigger harm. So here you have to weigh the consequences to see that, well, if forbidding that evil is going to lead to a bigger evil, then I would keep it the way it is, at least temporarily, until something else changes. But thirdly, you have a third kind of bid'ah which have a basis in the religion. You know, what we call sometimes the augmentative or the diminutive bid'ahs. And these kind of bid'ahs, of course, then you have to look at the dalil. So you don't deal with all the bid'ahs the same way. They don't lump them in the same basket and deal with them the same way. The third one, again, you look at the dalil. It's a matter of which one has a stronger basis and foundation. And as such, you may accept certain things and may reject certain things. So again, the Prophet ﷺ in this basic hadith is putting some guidelines for us to protect the religion and the practices of the religion. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us firm on His path in this life and the next. JazakumAllah khair. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.